picking up few good areas to talk about in such a big city like Bangalore was always going to be tough. That's why I got so many comments and trolls when I did this video. My name is Balaji Badrinath and I welcome you to my channel. And today in this video is dedicated to those who live in these evergreen areas, which is the topic of the day. Stay until the end of this video if you want to learn which is my personal choice for the best amongst these residential area, and also subscribe to my channel for more incredible real estate insights like today. Without further ado, let's begin. We are kicking off today's list with Rajarajeshwari Nagar, also known as RR Nagar. It is located in the southwestern part of Bangalore along the Mysore Road, with Nagarbhavi to the north and Kengeri to the west. There is a prominent arch-shaped structure on the Mysore Road which serves as the most popular entrance to this locality. The locality has plenty of greenery. It is home to many IT companies. Global Village Tech Park, spread over 120 acres, is located here. A number of prestigious companies' offices are present in the park. The locality has a blend of low to mid-rise apartment complexes, independent houses, as well as high-rise multi-story apartments. Key projects include like Prestige Bagmane Temple Bells, Shobha Valley View, Century Indus, among others. Key thing to note is metro connectivity is already in place and is going to be operational soon. Land prices are still cheaper compared to other developed areas, and anytime the best time to buy homes here. Coming at 9th place is Vijayanagar, a neighborhood in southwest Bangalore. Vijayanagar is in close proximity to RV College of Engineering, PS Institute of Technology, MS Ramaiah Institute of Technology, and the Bangalore University. It also houses a large public library, which is among the largest libraries in Karnataka. It enjoys ease of accessibility to various civic utilities. The locality serves to residences from independent houses to villas. It is one of the best residential places in Bangalore, having plenty of restaurants and shops. It has good number of trees and parks in the locality. Metro connectivity, which is already operational, is a blessing to this entire stretch, covering a lengthy west of Cod Road. Wide roads, plenty of green cover, temples, old town charm makes it a perfect place to live here for all age groups. Alsur or Halasuru is one of the oldest neighborhoods in the city of Bangalore. It is located in central Bangalore and begins roughly near the eastern terminus of MG Road. It is renowned for its numerous temples and rather narrow streets. Alsur is a major tourist attraction due to the presence of several beautiful temples and the Alsur Lake. The place is popular as a residential area due to the reasonable real estate rates and the easy connectivity with the rest of the city. The area is also connected through Namma Metro, buses, auto rickshaws and cabs to the rest of the city. Coming in the 7th place of our list, we have Yelahanka. It is located in the northern part of Bangalore, offers great investment opportunities for the home buyers with long-term plans. It is the nearest major locality to the Kempegowda International Airport, Devanahalli, and lately the Metro Link is also announced, which passes through it, connecting the airport. Gifted with better road connections compared to other potential localities in Bangalore, its connectivity to tech parks such as Manyata and to upcoming projects like Bangalore Aerospace, Bangalore International IT Investment Region and Disneyland Theme Park, Yelahanka in the North Bangalore is the fastest growing area and most suitable for investment without a second thought. Next up, we have Rajajinagar. It's a residential locality and business hub in the west of Bangalore. It is a very good area with a good mix of residential, commercial and industrial area. It is free from traffic problems and has very low air pollution. The last few years have been a tremendous growth of commercial activity and high-end residential apartments in and around Rajajinagar. With metro connectivity, the areas in and around metro station are bound to have a huge demand potential for commercial offices, showrooms and residential apartments. Large parcel of lands are now becoming commercial offices and malls. Needless to say, it is one of the best locations in Bangalore to live. Next up, we have Hebbal. Hebbal is relatively a new neighborhood and had become a prominent commercial locality in Bangalore. The prestigious 300-acre Manyata Tech Park stands tall in Nagavara, Hebbal. Thousands of employees work here. IBM, Cognizant, L&T, NXP Semiconductors, Fidelity Investments, Northern Trust are some of the companies in Manyata Tech Park. One can find easy connectivity to other parts of Bangalore because Hebbal flyover is unique in its construction as it connects the north, east and central part of Bangalore. It provides a better network for Outer Ring Road, Bellary Road and NH7. Upcoming metro services will be another feather in the cap to have a hassle-free journey. This will in turn increase demand for both commercial and residential activities. Hebbal, without a doubt, becoming the next upscale settlement areas of Bangalore. Sadashiv Nagar is an upscale residential neighborhood in Bangalore. The neighborhood houses plush homes, mansions of Bangalore's famous celebrities, politicians, and industrialists. Sadashiv Nagar has evolved to attract many home buyers due to its fantastic connectivity to IT hubs, including the Embassy Manyata Business Park and Kempegowda International Airport. Sadashiv Nagar borders the Sankey Tank, a mid-sized lake on the edge, and is sometimes used by residents for exercise. The plot sizes are generally in large dimensions, and one can find only luxury apartment projects here. If you want to brush shoulders with the movers and shakers of the city, then Sadashiv Nagar is the place for you to make your next home. Seshadripuram is a prime locality, residential and commercial, in the central part of the city of Bangalore. It is named after Sri K. Seshadri Iyer, who was a Diwan of Mysore state. It is also famous for its colleges. Some of the main colleges are the Seshadripuram Educational Institutions. It is one of the oldest residential settlement and rich in heritage. The second place in our list, we have Malleshwaram. Here, you will find Mantri Square, a shopping mall which is biggest in Karnataka and one of the biggest in India, with more than 35 different food kiosks and multiplex screens of PVR and Inox. Malleshwaram is a good neighborhood for children, youngsters, couples, families, and also for old age people, as it has the charm of this old beautiful Bangalore heritage style at the same time having a modern up. The Sankey Tank with gyms, very long walking track, and enough sitting benches is one of the biggest water body, a well-maintained public amenity in the city. It is an old residential locality in northwest of Bangalore. It is well connected to rail, bus, metro, and other means of transport. BMTC buses provide excellent service to Malleshwaram, covering Kempegowda International Airport, which is about 32 km away from this region. Bangalore railway station is just 4 km away from Malleshwaram. The quality of physical and social infrastructure is quite impressive, and you will have all the comfort that way. Schools, shopping malls, stores, banks, ATMs, hospitals are all situated in the vicinity. Whenever I visit Malleshwaram, I get a feel of peace, tranquility, and calmness. It's a great choice to make your home here. At first spot, we have Basavanagudi. With Ramakrishna Mutt right next door, one cannot miss the lush, tranquil, and untamed views of the ashram when they are in Basavanagudi. It is considered to be the most posh and heritage part of Bangalore. It is also known for its historical temples and eateries. It is located in the heart of South Bangalore, where the charm of old Bangalore still exists. This old residential area is characterized by large trees, old temples, and beautiful houses. This suburb was once home to many cultural icons of Bangalore. This area is preferred for residential purposes as it is surrounded by markets, cultural institutions, parks, and restaurants. It also enjoys easy connectivity to several areas of Bangalore. So, what are your thoughts on these incredible evergreen residential areas where you can choose to live in Bangalore? Let me know in the comments below. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you next time.